Hello guys, welcome to my tutorial. Well, in this tutorial, I would like to tell you and show you about how to make a control to your character in your game. And in this case, I'd like to use an application called Constructu. So, let's just get started. First of all, you have to open Constructu. And then after that, you'll face a view like this. This is the default startup view of your application. First of all, you have to click File and then click New. After that, there are some templates that you can use. These templates can make us the developers to make issues to make the game. Like this in the jumping, slow defense, driving game, and etc. But in here we just need to use a new empty project. So let's just click open, and this is your first view of your project. And in this case you will see a breaking line in here. This means that this is the border of your game. So whatever the thing or something that is outside from this breaking line will be visible. Alright, let's just get started. First, I will put background to this layout one. Okay, so just double click, and here you can see many things that you get input to your project. Then so the background, it will be a sprite. You just insert it, and then click, and you will be, and there will be a view like this. Then you just need to click open, and then stop. And you should find your trajectory. So here I like to open my background, then close it. So if you want to minimize your view, I just need to press Control and minus like this, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So if you wanna fit your background with your project, that means should be fit your project. And then this is a very important thing, you have to add your character. Just do the same thing like that, double click and then click sprite and then insert and click, and so the same window will be open like before. And then we don't have to need to open the file in here, but because it's an animation, you have to load it from here. The right click and then import frames, and then click from sprite strip, and then I choose Pikachu and here, which is my character. Well, I'm sorry, but I forget about the with 3 and then 4. I mean, it's a sprite file. You know, sprite is the movement of your character, or like an animation, like a guideline for your animation. So let's repeat it again. Put frames and click from sprite strip. Then I'd like to choose it, PKG. So this is the horizontal there. In my spreadsheet there are 3 pictures, and then vertically there are 4 pictures. And then I replace axis animation. This is unused, as you see, and click OK. Click OK and wait a little while, and this is your animation. See, this is the movement of your character. Like so. In this case, I'd like to a little bit minimize it, and then close it. Let's setting the size of your character. Oh yeah, don't forget to setting. If you want to a loop animation, then click yes, because it's a running animation, so we have to make it as loop. And the speed is the speed of your animation, but basically I always use 20 frames per second. Let's close it. And in this case, you have to add a behavior for your character. The behavior should be, and you should click behavior and click the plus, and you have to find something like 8 directional, and this behavior will be make your character able to move 8 direction. And in this case, set angle time, the set angle option, we should not put it because it will change your pictures too. So we just need to make it know. And then don't forget to change the speed, it's up to you actually. So I set it as 600. And then 600. Okay. In this case, let's go to the event sheet, and here you can find an empty event sheet. This sheet is actually for your algorithm of your game. So actually, the system of your game will be put in here. So we just need to add an event, and then, I forget to add a keyboard. If you wanna control the character with keyboard, then you have to use keyboard. But if you wanna control it with your mouse or thoughts, but this is a touch screen system, and you should choose this. But like now, I will show you about the controller of the keyboard. Like this, after we click it, aspect event sheet and add event, and you can see keyboard is available in here, not like before. And double click it, and choose when key is down. And then the key is down and next, and then you click to choose, and you put what key that you wanna choose it. For example, I'd like to use a W, and then okay, and down. And in this case, when W is down, something will happen. So what will happen? What will happen is, despite, I mean, your character will be moving. So click your character like this, double click, and then simulate control, and then select left, right, up, out, down. You wanna control character left, so just need to use and choose left and down. In this case, the character will be moved to left. So we just need to copy this and paste, and I just need to change it like A, because basically the most game use this directional. They use WASD for controlling their character actually. So let's choose S and then D. Don't forget to change the simulate, of course. A4 left. Oh, I'm sorry, I make a mistake actually. W is for up. Oh man. And S is for down, and then D is for right. So as you can see, it's already made like this, and then you can back to layout 1, and let's make a preview for your project. You should find run layout on the left side like this and click. So you have to a little bit wait, of course. I'm sorry, I'm not that concentrated. I'm a bit tired. Yeah, as you can see, this is your character. And when you press T, it will move to right, and when you press A, it moves to left, and W for up, and S is for down. But in this case, we still not at some portal for your game, so actually your character can still move to outside of the game actually and disappear just like this. Oh my god, he's gone. Oh, he's back. Oh, he's gone. Well, that's it. And thanks for the time to watching my video. And I'm really sorry if I not that good showing you the tutorial, but if you have questions, you can comment or contact me on YouTube. Okay, that's all for me, and thank you.